Shirley, thank you very much for having us here today.
I'd like to welcome you very much because I think there are parallels, of course, in the textile and the leather industry, especially on sustainability.
Why is sustainability and taking a leading role in sustainability so important for yourself and for your company?
It's very important for me because I am the fifth generation of our company's family company, same as Smit, of course. And I think that it's my added value in this generation to give the family company to the next generation. That's the first drive I have to make this industry more sustainable.
Mm-hmm. Leather is a byproduct of the meat industry. When the meat is produced, a byproduct is the hide. And the hide in a process.
Hide is skin.
The skin,
more or less.
Yeah. Is transferred into leather articles, shoes, bags, chairs, and seats in public transportation. If you look around, leather is basically everywhere. And for me, leather could be the ultimate circular cradle-to-cradle material. What was for you the first moment in your career when you conceived the topic of making the value chain circular?
Well, the first maybe is the social part of it, because we used to make production here in Hilvarenbeek in the Netherlands until 2010, more or less. The last couple of years before 2010, we started to work abroad. And then you have your value chain somewhere else. That was already a part of experiencing that you have influence on the other side of the world and that you can actually do something better there. Then after, I think, 5 more years later, I saw all these documentaries about the horrible environmental impact of the textile industry. And I think the same is for the leather industry.
Yeah.
Where I was thinking, okay, maybe we can do it in a different way. And then finally in 2017 we had made the first circular production.
And how come that you were the first company to make that step?
Because we are a small company, we are able to do so. Also because we're a family company, I make my own decisions. If I feel this is the right way, let's try it. And if we fail, then we try it again or we try it on a different way.
But you still need to take a customer along, or you need one or two customers who want to...
Launching customer is important. Then you have to talk about partnership. Mm-hmm. And circularity is all about partnership because you are partners in the value chain.
Mm-hmm. Now, there's a great parallel with what we are doing. In the leather value chain, there is the leather working group, which audits the tanneries and looks at social, environmental...
Oh, both.
Conditions in the tanneries,
okay.
Health, safety, environment. And then we work with ZDHC and we are ZDHC level 3 certified for part of our portfolio now.
Does the customer know this ZDHC certification?
That is the challenge we are in, to really give that transparency throughout the whole chain, but also market and educate every player in the chain on what is being done at the different stages, and ultimately we need to tell that to the end consumer as well.
And I'd say that we have a job to do in breaking the patterns, because 7 generations ago business was also different as nowadays.
Yep.
So every generation is breaking a pattern from the last generation.
Yep.
And that's why we should break patterns again.
Yep, fully agree.
Yeah.
Shirley, thank you very much for this talk we could have on this interesting topic.
I like
a lot of parallels between our companies, a lot of parallels between the two value chains. Thanks. Thank you.